the focus of this whole festival is for present a platform for independent filmmakers who are in the St. Petersburg, Tampa, Florida area. We want to develop an audience by screening your films here and providing network opportunities so you can meet other real filmmakers that are making films in the community. And hopefully they can form alliances or partnerships with them and move your next projects forward. Okay? Now the focus really is on do-it-yourself filmmaking. We're not talking about going out to Hollywood and raising $2 or $3 million to make a movie. That's a very, very competitive process there. And for new filmmakers, that's not going to happen for you. I mean, usually, if you go out there, you have to have a finished product already, your track record, before you can take meetings. And it's really difficult to take meetings. But we don't want you just to sit around here waiting for people to call you. We want you to start making a product, making films that then you can show somehow to people so that you can see your work. So the real focus is going to be on do-it-yourself filmmaking here. And what I'm going to, let me get my tool over here. I'm not going to talk about me right now. This is a little handout here. If you look at the bottom, you can find my IMDb site. And it blows out pretty good. And you can check here to see my credits. I'm not talking about me today, but I'm going to talk about the process of how to make a film. And what I'm going to start off with is to show you some clips of a film that I produced over this past year in St. Petersburg. It's a project called the Nouveau Linea, and there's a link to it on the back. But last February, I just started from scratch with putting together a production of local people. I used about 20 local actors, so I give actors an opportunity to perform in front of an audience, in front of a screen, learn about the filmmaking process. About 5 production people, so about 25 people. And I shot it in 4K. And now, after a year, I have a 115-minute feature film, which will be screening at the Sundial at AMC Theater on February 7th. That'll be our premiere. During this festival, I just wanted to show a little teaser, about 8 minutes, so that you can see the quality of what you can get for almost no budget. And as I state in here, we made a 115-minute 4K film for less than $2,500 of cash outlay. Now, a lot of that was voluntary time of everybody involved. But everybody got fed, which is important. But with a little bit of a cash outlay, you can make a feature-length film, a 4K feature-length film here in St. Petersburg. So this is an inspirational, motivational thing. A lot of people make short films, which is wonderful as a start. But there is a path to going from there to a feature film, which you then can send out to festivals and out to Hollywood. So I'm going to show you a little clip from that. In my house, say 9 feet by 14 feet, and I was able to shoot a lot of scenes there. And then I laid nice backdrops, either stills backdrops or 4K backdrops to that. So it gives it both the style of being a stage theatrical piece for the future scenes, but also realistic scenes for the contemporary situation. So it's a mixture. It's a hybrid, a movie. But I like that since it's a digital age, you have to learn how to use the digital tools. Everything was done with the Adobe CC suite of tools, of Premiere and After Effects and Photoshop and for sound audition. So there was a low cost of entry to use those tools on a PC. But you're going to see the quality on the 4K camera that I got, which you can buy at Best Buy now for about $850. It looks good when you blow it up on a big screen. We screened the segments of this movie a couple of times throughout theaters here in St. Petersburg, AMC, with it. And Johnny will talk about his short film festival he holds every month. And then also up in Tampa, in Bellagio Theater. So there are outlets for filmmakers in a theatrical setting for your movie. And on the big screen, this 4K film is pretty good. So I'm just going to show you a little segment of this. See, pretty good on Visually, it looks pretty good, the image quality. And the nice thing about green screen is that you could always drop new and better either still images or 4K video clips over these when you do a chroma keying thing using Adobe Premiere. So as I'm doing now, and I will continue to do, I will update the quality of the background, make it more dynamic to whatever I want. But for the first version, I think that the image looks pretty good. Okay, now, again, this whole seminar, the whole weekend is a do-it-yourself thing. For people that want to make films, we're not assuming that you've made any type of film at all. But I'm going to share with you the process that I use as a filmmaker to get to where I am right now. If you've never made a film before, what you want to do is start out with making a short film. Come up with a story that's maybe about 5 minutes long, maybe 10 minutes long. You know, you set your goals for something that's achievable, and it's going to be a learning process. In your first film, you're always going to make tremendous amount of mistakes, so you don't want to put a lot of cost into it. You want it to be a learning experience. I would say you kind of sketch out an idea, you kind of write a script, no more than 5 pages, maybe 10 pages, and you try to shoot it on some weekend. The best process is to shoot it, say, within a 4-hour stretch. Now you book it, your time slot from 1 to 5 on some Saturday afternoon, because a lot of people that you're going to be bringing on as actors or production people usually work. They have full-time jobs. They have to make money to sustain themselves. So you don't put pressure and stress on them. You create an environment where you can do something. So usually, start off with a short film. And to create a story in a short film, I'm just going to be hitting the bullet points that are on this front sheet over here. Everybody has one of these sheets that they can follow? Okay, if not, please get one over here. But what's the basis of the story? Okay, let's take one of these two. In the story, what you need is some character. You need something that's called the hero, but they call it the protagonist. You need some main character. And you set it up so that main character has a goal. They want to achieve something, okay, within that 5 minutes. So you need a character with an objective, a character with a goal. But the real issue, the real essence of drama is that you create conflict. Now, how do you create conflict? Well, you create obstacles to that character achieving this goal. This is the common essence of what a story is. And usually, to make it more dramatic, make it more human interest, you have another character who's called the antagonist, who is somehow trying to block that first character from achieving what they want. Does that make sense? You see that all the time. This is the craft of filmmaking. Somebody wants something, has a desire, that's his goal, or her goal, but somebody's blocking it. So your story is, how does he overcome those obstacles that the other person is trying to block? Now, that's the essence of the story, but it's also the essence of the scene. Each scene really deals with a character that's trying to achieve something and is being blocked in that scene by somebody else or some other obstacle that's blocking them from achieving what they want to achieve. So for your first thing, if you've never done anything, try to design a little story that you can shoot in 4 hours in some location that's easy. I would recommend some location inside, somebody's house, somebody's apartment, somebody's warehouse even, because the toughest thing that a filmmaker has to deal with is sound, okay? Especially exterior sound, sound outside, where there are cars going by or noises in the street. Every filmmaker deals with that problem, and it'll hurt your film if you don't have quality sound. So the best way to eliminate that is to try to get an enclosed location for your first short film, so that sound is not really going to be a problem for you. Right? So I'll get into equipment and so forth, an overview of that, but that's the essence of a story. Once you made your first short film, you have to realize that a narrative film is just a whole group of 5-minute films, okay? If you do 25-minute segments, you're going to get 100 minutes. You do 112 5-minute segments. What's that gonna be, 60? Okay, so if you do 18 5-minute segments, you're gonna have a 90-minute film. And that's the way to think of a do-it-yourself thing. You schedule something every weekend on a Saturday or every other weekend, twice a month you do this. If you learn how to schedule right, you can do 4 hours in the morning and 4 hours in the afternoon. So if you get 5 minutes for each time, that's 10 minutes on a Saturday, you do it on a Sunday, all of a sudden you have 20 minutes. You do that for 3 weekends in a month, you have 60 minutes of footage, okay? And then if you still continue to do that with retakes, a 5-minute segment every other weekend or something, before you know it, you have a 90-minute or 120-minute film by working on these segments. Now, to go from a small one scene, a short film, into, a 120-minute film, what you have to have is characters and the audience that's engaging. Characters that the audience has empathy for and wants to watch and see what happens to them. So you have to create an ensemble type of actors and characters. Now for a no-budget film, you have to have actors who are committed to your project. Okay? That's a good way to think about the movie business, because a lot of the films that are made are the franchises, but they're recurring characters. You can think of a TV show as the beginning, but you get remakes or remakes or remakes. I don't know, you're going to do Avengers or X-Men or Star Wars or any of these series out there, in Jack Reacher, anything there, Mission Impossible. It's a character that keeps on recurring, because what happens is that you build an audience. And the audience then identifies with these characters and want to come back to see them in new projects. So if you can do that when you're starting thinking, how can I take these actors and characters in different situations and create a whole lot of little series? Now, so audience identification, it is very important. Now, I use Facebook and YouTube a lot and social media in order to both motivate my cast and crew and also to start building an audience. So what I did, you think of YouTube as your dailies. You're posting your dailies. You're posting segments on YouTube. You create a YouTube group, a YouTube page for your project. In this case, Novolindia is the project. And every time I shoot something, I do a quick cut, a rough cut, and I throw it up there. That way the actors can then take that and put it onto their page. They can share it on their page, because actors have their careers beside your specific project. So if you're helping them with giving them demo sets, demo reels that they can then spread out there to their agents, to other filmmakers, producers, that's good. That's a value that they're getting. They're not getting cash, but they're getting a media presence out there. And so that's important. I don't care how many views I get on those initially, because that's not the finished product, but it's like the dailies that I'm sharing with people on social media. So it's always important to get a Facebook page and so forth. So later on we'll talk about raising money through crowdfunding like Indiegogo, Kickstarter, Patreon. But that's kind of saturated right now. Maybe 5 years ago, it was an important way of raising funds. But so many people have done it, so many people have tried it, that's really hard to make money on that right now. Especially if you're just starting from scratch. If you're just starting from a concept, a story idea, you try to raise money, it's really hard to do that because it's not a new thing anymore. And even some of the professionals have tried that to raise $250,000 or so. It's a difficult process now. I'm going to be using it because I'm going to be taking this film to the American film market next November. So to raise promotional marketing money, I'll try that at that end. But for production money, it's almost impossible to raise funds that way. And this is something you have to get beyond as a new filmmaker. You can't just write a script and hopefully someone will give you $50,000 or $250,000 to make a feature film. That's almost impossible to happen right nowadays, unless you have a rich relative or somehow you connected with some people that have money that they want to flow into your project. That way of getting a film made is almost impossible to accomplish. That's why the best process is just to pick it up, start it, and move forward, scene by scene. A lot of people say, well, let's start it as a web series. Hey, that's good, start it as a web series, put it on YouTube, or put it on Vimeo, or put it on Amazon, build your audience, do segments here and there, but with the end mind that you're gonna link all those segments together into at least a 90-minute movie. Because unless you have a 90-minute movie, you're not gonna get into the theatrical distribution, you're not gonna get into theaters or foreign markets. There's almost no money flowing back to short films. Almost no money at all. Maybe get a little bit on Vimeo. Even YouTube, in the beginning, you could monetize your product out there, but nowadays, you have to have 10,000 subscribers, existing 10,000 subscribers, before they'll let you monetize any video. So nowadays, and for a new film, you're not gonna get 10,000 subscribers off the bat. If you wanna go into the digital streaming with your short segments as a web series, I recommend going on to Amazon. You all know Amazon, they sell books on Amazon, you sell DVDs on Amazon. Amazon has a new business out there called AVD, Amazon Video Direct. And you can upload for free your video segments, 5-10 minute segments, and then they'll start streaming through the old Amazon Global Network, and they'll start giving you some money based upon who watches the screens. Now, the thing about Amazon is that they're one of the wealthiest companies in the country, and they're looking for product. They did Manchester by the Sea with Casey Affleck 2 years ago. They financed that. Casey Affleck is Ben Affleck's brother, so he's not an 80-plus lister like Ben. He's a small B type of character there. But they picked up his movie and they sent it out there. So if you start getting into the Amazon platform, Amazon people are looking at people. So all my source material is good, and I'm keeping that because what that means, when I bring it into my timeline, if you know editing, I bring it in as 4K, so all my projects are based with 4K going from their sources, but when I output it as an export, I go out into 1920x1080. What that means is that when I'm ready to burn 4K DVDs, I got all the source there, I just do an export into 4K format and put on 4K DVDs. You go to Best Buy right now, all the television sets are 4K, right? Samsung, Sony, all 4K. You get a 4K Blu-ray burner, 4K Blu-ray player for about less than $200 now during Christmas. So the format is moving to 4K. But if you shoot at 4K now, you have all that legacy source files in your timeline, and then you can burn it to 4K when you're ready. You can buy 4K DVDs at Best Buy right now, but the market is not there yet, and most people don't have it. But if you shoot in 4K, you have that capability. Now, this one camera, there's a lot of other cameras out there, and I'm not going to go through the list. You can get a Blackmagic camera for a couple thousand dollars. The Reds, if you heard about the Reds, now you're really to get a Red, it's $15,000, $25,000, maybe up to $50,000, which is